Seven Habits of Highly Self-Confident People. Written by Can Akdeniz. Narrated by David Willams. Preface. When you lack confidence, you basically lack the very engine that can propel you into the successosphere. No matter how great your skills, talent, and dedication, your actions will be deprived of that energy capable of manifesting into reality those things designed by intention and imagination if you're not in touch with yourself, trusting your essence and your true potential. Have you ever felt paralyzed by self-doubt and gave in to hesitation only to have regrets afterwards and sink into lower self-esteem even for a little? It's okay. All of us have. And all of us need to learn how to develop more self-confidence so we can pursue our dreams more empowered. If you're ready to commit to taking your self-confidence to an unprecedented level in your life, this is the time to do it. This is the book to get you started. What stands between you and the success you might have, the accomplishments you are capable of, the prosperity you deserve, can be much easier to overcome than you might imagine. The first thing that you need to be confident about is that you too can become extremely confident. Even if you can't find the resources to believe that, give yourself a chance by listening to this book and you might find your life changed. Confidence is what you get when you have cultivated the right habits. This book reveals them to you along with tips on how to apply them. You already have various habits which pay off more or less in terms of what you want from life. How about replacing some of those habits or adding seven more and finally become that highly confident and successful person you can truly be? Introduction. Confidence, for many, the mother of all traits. If you don't share this view, you may ask why. I'll try using my personal experience to make it a little clearer. Throughout the years, I have met and talked to many successful people. While every single one of them seemed to emanate to such a high degree pure, unadulterated confidence, with some of them I actually got to address the topic itself, and the answer was always the same. It's a process that is always progressing depending on how much of yourself you invest in it. Rarely, confidence just drops from the sky like a gift from the heavens. It is built. It's true that some people tend to be naturally more confident than others, or that this process we've mentioned does not take the same amount of time for everybody. It's common sense. We're different, and that's a good thing. However, with the right set of tools, anybody can shake off their shyness, reserve, and uncertainty, and become more in touch with themselves and with their true potential. Because, ultimately, it's about that exact inner potential that's hidden most of the times by our own layers of doubts and fears. But this potential is always there, waiting for us to release it and manifest all those things we are capable of, and which, unfortunately, we deny ourselves much too often. Confidence nurtures action, and action leads to success. But first we must find out those things that nurture confidence itself and cultivate them in such a way that we strengthen this core to the point we can no longer fall back to our zone of fear and disbelief, even if our plans don't always succeed, even if we are exposed or expose ourselves to voices that willingly, or not, speak to bring us down. I am writing this book to let you know you don't have to feel guilty for not scoring big time in the confidence department. I'm writing this book to let you know that you can be just as big as you think you can be, but also just as little. I am writing this book to remind you that you owe it to yourself to tap into the source that can unleash all the creative force you have within you. Even if you're having doubts such a force could exist in you, or although you feel you have it but its strength is nowhere near the strength of your fears, the fact that you are listening to this book now shows that you want to tap into that source and are allowing yourself the chance to elevate from whatever level of confidence you find yourself at this moment. The sooner you start seeing confidence as an ability that can be worked on and improved, the sooner you will notice your first results in this respect. No matter how powerful external events and negative stimuli can be, once you get to master this ability, you will actually feed off the apparent adverse circumstance and be inspired by the most opposing odds. You will literally have people around wonder and even ask what is your secret. Some believe confidence cannot be taught. You either have it or you don't. They're wrong. Some of the clients I've trained had plunged so low in the abyss of insecurity that they were having a hard time finding a reason to live. One of them even told me it took him 2 months to finally decide and email me after initially receiving a recommendation from a mutual friend. He was so desperately in need of a boost in self-esteem and confidence, he eventually gathered his courage to call in for help. And he was so glad.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.